name and he owe me some money.
I need that.
Hit him with the
Don't be
whitey playing games. They don't want no problems with me. My got good. I know I brought them. Might not hit a bad. Someone send them to opposition.
Say move wrong.
So I
dark shades, too much. I can barely see them. Acting brand new like I don't see it when I do. Who them folks? Who want too close? Give me room, phony folks. Play it close, do the most, don't they? Bad company, that's bad for your company.
Strange.
Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad cow disease, now you in a ton of beef. Tucked underneath my new blue dunkaries. Flintstone, bust down, color Maricami. Fruity pepper, bezel, Wilma, Betty, Fred, and Barney. Bad. I'm out of town, I think she model Abercrombie. Risk game, lucky charmy, told my jeweler leprechaun. I'ma come clean, I got E. Paranoia got me rolling on my sleeves, okay. Dating cause I'm up and up the fees. Whole team got bees on their teeth all day. I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing all my Z's all day. Good Lord, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frightened when I up it, I'ma squeeze.
I'm above average.
Money back.
Back now on EA Sports at Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. We're in quarter number two, and it's the Lions who are in possession of the football. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll run it here with Blunt. And able to pushes way forward here for a good little game. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Out of the gun, Stafford. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. Two minutes remain here in the first half. Back to the booth right after this. A reminder coming up at halftime. The coach is back. He made it through the first weekend. That's the good news, and he's going to regale you with stats and scores from around the NFL here in the early games in week two.
You think he questioned coming back for week two, having to work with us?
I think he did. He's just happy that he is far away in Orlando. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing, playing against a good quarterback like he is, to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys.
And he has his receiver. That's Jones. Lions touchdown. Marvin Jones, his second touchdown on the season. And the Lions are able to grow their lead. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Garoppolo again here on second and 10. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Garrett Celek, the tight end, was the target. And it'll bring up third down. Boy, the numbers throwing the football just not trending in the right direction. Last week he was under 50%. He's under 50% again here.
And we haven't gotten an announcement, but it appears to me that he might be a little dinged up and is just trying to play through. You know, he's one of those tough guys that wants to answer the bell each and every play for his team. That might be throwing off his accuracy.
And this one will go to the 28-yard line. And now the Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it.
Here we go. 180.
They run for it with Morris. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
Wow. I'll tell you, he got a good spot on that one. It's fourth and two, and he might have gotten two and an inch, but that's all he needed, and that'll keep the drive moving.
Now a play fake here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Now Garoppolo on the bootleg. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Here's Morris. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. And we're going to get another timeout called by the Lions, as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Again, the offense will stay out there. They've converted once on this drive. What can they do here on fourth down? They do go for it. It's Garoppolo. And it is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Lions will get the football back in terrific field position. Down, Stafford here. That is caught at the 7. And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. As his guys are in for 6, and the Lions add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Prater on to add the extra point. Prater for the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Here's Prater now set to kick it away. Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. 13 seconds, the time remaining in the half as they come up on first down. Throwing on first is Garoppolo. And he finds his target. It's Marquise Goodwin. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there, 8 yards.